Hi YouTube, Marcus here. Gonna take a fairly detailed look at this new cable from Corsair. This is the premium individually sleeved version of the same cable, which is a ribbon cable. This is the individually sleeved. Package contents, total measurement width with a 4080-4090 experimental woodblock GPU, more on that. Availability and PSU compatibility for this cable, and some final thoughts. So stay tuned and we'll get to it.
Okay, let's take a look at this cable. Pros and cons. A lot of pros actually. This is really a nice cable. Individually stranded. Not much in the package, just some safety and compliance. Not an instruction manual, not an installation manual. So a little explanation is needed. This cable is designed for delivering 600 watts over two strands, two separate power connectors from the 16-pin power connector at the GPU. The nice thing about this cable that the ribbon cable, the cheaper ribbon cable, does not have is this block. This is a cable block, let's call it. And it's designed to prevent you from bending the cable too close to the power connector, which, as we know, or maybe you don't, this has caused a lot of issues with people melting their GPUs or their cables or both because of putting stress on this part of the connector or not inserting this connector fully into the GPU, the 4000 series GPU. So Corsair has intelligently put this suggested minimum distance here, which is looks to me about 2 inches or so from the actual connector, and you should bend there after and down. So that's nice. That's gonna give me an idea of what the distance I need in my case is to put this, if it can fit. The other thing I should mention, it's not a cheap cable. This is about 63 Canadian. It did ship from California very quickly, 2 days, so kudos to Corsair for that. But it is not cheap. I cannot find it at retail stores in Canada currently. Only the ribbon cable is available. A little disappointing though is no cable combs. Although this is kind of weird wires, there's going to be an explanation in the video later on, but there are no combs at all. And for a premium cable of this price, you'd think that they would include some cable combs, even if the wiring is a bit bizarre or different. Let's call it different, not bizarre, but different. Anyway, let's get on to some width measurements for case compatibility. Okay, we're back and we have our cable bent to where I feel is comfortable for these wires, and I would be happy with, and we'll take a measurement. Of course, this is going to be the other way around, but this is the key thing is to have this inserted into the on the piece of wood here so that we count for that. So the total distance here where I feel the bend is okay, maybe I'll put that on that side for you to see better, is about 8 1/4 inches, let's call it. You could probably go with that, or 210 millimeters to 220 millimeters depending on your liking. So that is what you will need in terms of width for a 4080-4090 card from the sort of base of after the actual PCIe fin, the base of the card, to the bend in the cable, which is quite a bit. So be prepared that you will need clearance for such a premium cable.
Okay, PSU compatibility. Let's see where we can find that out. If you go to Corsair's site and look for this cable specifically, you will come to this location from which you can purchase it. In Canada, you can't purchase this from a retailer currently. They're not stocked. So you'll have to order this from Corsair directly, or Amazon.com in the US you can order it from, but not Amazon.ca. Various color options, which are shown down here. And what you are looking for is check PSU compatibility. Click that link. You will come to this table, which is quite important. And type 4, it has an orange dot. So we're looking for type 4, then PCIe on the left, and you can see which models AX and HX series are compatible. So a lot of them are. I'll tell you the AX older models are not. So you need AX Platinum and HX Bronze are not. Scrolling further down to the RM and CS series and TX series, some models are, well, actually most of the models it looks like, except for the SF. So that's what you will need to know for pre-purchasing a cable and compatibility. Okay, one thing I forgot to show you initially is the important data or communications cable included in this Gen 5 cable. This is on the far right hand side of this photo. It's a thinner cable that one for each of the strands that is connected to, this is the PSU end of the cable. But if you look at the other side, that is the GPU connector, you'll see there's two, one for each strand, and it's going into the data port on top of the actual connector. And this tells the GPU, these two cables tell the GPU just what's connected to it, how many cables and what power capability they have to deliver the wattage necessary for your 4000 series GPU. So that's a very important couple of cables, and maybe the reason why the cable combs weren't included, because it's a kind of a funny number of cables in the end. Not sure about that, but anyway, that's an important thing to be aware of. Final thoughts. The biggest one is you don't have to change your Corsair PSU for an RTX 4000 GPU. You can use your current GPU as long as you have enough power to drive them without having to look for so-called Gen 5 PSU out there. It's a premium cable. It does look good. I'm an individually sleeved fan as opposed to the old ribbon cables that look like something from the padded drives back in the late 90s, 2000s. Or earlier. Useful strand block for minimum bend distance. Yes, that's a useful thing, I think, and gives you a guide as to where not to bend the cable too close to the connector. 600 watts with just two PSU connectors. That is the biggest selling point for me, minimizing the number of cables and octopus coming out of your 4000 series GPU with the standard Nvidia connector. Many Corsair PSUs are compatible, in fact, so it's only a few AX, older AX Gold series that are not, but costly, and perhaps a wide PC case is required. So I hope this width distance measurement is useful. And with that, I say thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you next time with another Marcus video. Take care. Bye-bye.